Hi, Andy Granowitz here, developer advocate for Google Analytics. Today, I'm going to talk a little about setting up Google Analytics for the first time. Google Analytics is known for being straightforward to deploy on your website or app. And although this is true, there are a few important things to consider when you install Google Analytics for the first time to make sure you get the most out of the powerful features that Google Analytics offers. The most basic measurement is going to be page view or screen view tracking on web and app respectively. For most websites, setting up page view tracking is straightforward. Add the Google Analytics JavaScript snippet on every page, and Google Analytics will count each time the page is loaded. This is a little bit more involved on mobile apps, but once you set up screen view tracking using the iOS or Android SDK, the results are very similar. Google Analytics will measure a lot by default, even with this basic setup. For example, with just page or screen view tracking, Google Analytics will automatically allow you to analyze session duration, time on specific pages or screens, geo information like city and state, technology data like mobile device or browser, user flow between pages or screens, and where users are coming from, like search engines, social networks, referrals from other sites, and so on. So there's a lot that's captured automatically. But with some customization, Google Analytics can capture user interactions that are unique to your site or app and that are really important to your business. Google Analytics offers many different customizations for many different use cases, ranging from measuring e-commerce to how long resources take to load. But there are three that I'd like to highlight when first getting set up: events, custom dimensions, and campaign tagging. Events are used to measure interactions within a given page. In other words, anything that is not a page load or a new screen. But keep in mind that you don't need to measure everything. Think about what are the most important user interactions and plan to measure those. This will prevent data overload when doing analysis. Custom dimensions. As we discussed, Google Analytics captures a lot of data by default, but often the most important information is very specific to your business, making it difficult for Google Analytics to measure without a little help from you. With custom dimensions, you can send custom data to Google Analytics, which will automatically get correlated with all of the other data that Google Analytics collects. For example, when signing up for your newsletter, if the user has the option to identify their industry, you may want to pass this information as a custom dimension. Another example might be when a user signs up for your service, whether they signed up for the 30-day trial, a standard membership, or a premium membership. The final customization that I'd like to talk about is campaign tagging. Google Analytics looks at the HTTP refer and does its best to figure out where your traffic is coming from. But when you run custom campaigns, like through an ad network, or if you're doing some email marketing, or really any other medium, you can use the Google Analytics URL builder to add query parameters to the URL you're promoting to your users. When users click on that link, the parameters you've added are automatically recognized by Google Analytics, so in your reports, you'll be able to find out exactly which campaigns brought users to your site or app and what they ultimately did. One special case, if you use AdWords, I strongly recommend that you link Google Analytics and AdWords accounts. By doing so, your AdWords campaigns will automatically get tagged with campaign parameters, and a lot of other valuable data will be imported into your Google Analytics account. In addition to this deep integration with AdWords, Google Analytics can also integrate with other Google products, such as AdSense, Webmaster Tools, AdMob, and more. Be sure to find out if there is an easy way to connect Google Analytics and whatever technologies you are using, whether they are Google or not. For more information on these customizations and more, check out the links below or go to developers.google.com/analytics.